Opryland in Nashville. This is Ralph Emery with special guest this week from Globe, Arizona, Miss Sammi Smith. And tonight we welcome back to Nashville, Tennessee, the wild man, Roger Miller.
All right.
Well, here I sit high, getting ideas. Ain't nothing but a fool to live like this. Out all night and running wild. Woman sitting home with a month-old child. Dang me, dang me. They ought to take a rope and hang me. High from the highest tree. Woman, would you weep for me? One more time, just sitting around drinking with the rest of the guys. 6 rounds bought and I bought 5. And I spent the groceries and half the rent, like $14.27. So dang me, dang me. They ought to take a rope and hang me. High from the highest tree. Woman, would you weep for me? One more time ago. Roses are red, violets are purple, and sugar's sweet, and so is maple syrup. Now I'm a 7th out of 7 sons. My pappy's a pistol, I'm a son of a gun. I said, dang me, dang me. They ought to dig a rope and hang me. Well, high from the highest tree. Oh, excuse me. I lapsed into a trance there for a second or so. That song just kind of does those things to me, you understand? It's a religious cult that I belong to. There's a small group of us. We gather in the early weeks, one of the earlier weeks of July each year, and we worship this old woman who lives in Utah. And she can tell time by beating a dead salmon against a Bodark fence post. And if you buy that, I got some swamp land down in Florida I'd like to talk to you about after the show. Woman, would you weep for me?
And here he is, live and direct from Eric, Oklahoma, ladies and gentlemen, Roger Miller.
Hey!
Or maybe we could do it. Here he is from the Amarillo Fire Department.
Oh, my gosh, just freshly fired. Or maybe I've got to go, really. I've got a plane to catch.
Have you really? You ain't going to make it.
I know it. How you been?
I've been terrific, Roger. I trust you have.
Yeah.
We're doing this show in Nashville where Roger used to hang out and write hit songs. But you live in California, don't you?
Been out there 15 years now.
You bought Clint Walker's house one time, didn't you?
One time, yeah. And then I sold it, and I've moved all around out there. I now live in Bert Schneider's house.
Who is Bert Schneider?
Who the hell knows? It's a nice place.
I want you to do something for me, and you probably could have guessed it.
What?
Because it's what I always have always asked you to do, the telephone call.
I've forgotten that thing. I think I can't do it anymore.
Now you got to do the dialing.
I know, that's what I can't hardly do. I don't... Hello. 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 I can't quite understand you.
I can't hear you either.
Hello.
Hello. I can't hear you.
I can't hear you.
I can't hear
you. Hello.
Hello. Hello.
Hello. Hello.
I've always liked that. You used to do all kinds of crazy little sounds.
Yeah.
I've always thought you wanted to be a sound man.
I used to do that out of a shortage of musical talent or something. I'd go as far as I could, and then I'd have to go. And I do heartbeats and things like that.
Well, heartbeats?
I don't know if it'll come out again. I do a. And for those of you out there who might be in the medical profession, you might enjoy the heart murmur, which is. That's about the.
Since you have become so sophisticated,
yes.
In California, have you forgotten the art of eefing?
Huh?
Eefing.
I'll leave that up to Mac Davis.
Does he eve?
He tries. Right. I don't ever do that anymore. I've really outgrown all the childish stuff. Oh. And I'm really a first-class act now, you know. I don't...
You don't...
Orange, since Sammy Smith's on the show today, just while I think of it, I want to tell you a funny story.
All right.
This truck driver, for 20 years, drove the big rigs. And he decided to retire, and he was going to become a country singer. And his first release was, "Take the ribbons from your hair. Shake it loose and let it fall."
Well, since you brought up Sammy Smith, why don't we bring her on? Let me preface what she's about to sing by telling you that I think this is one of the prettiest records she's ever made. And it's really a musical tribute to Marilyn Monroe. And as most of you movie buffs know, her real name is Norma Jean. And so that is the name of the song. Ladies and gentlemen, here is Sammy Smith.
She was born in L.A. in a lonely room. Hardly knew her mama, and her daddy left too soon. She never seemed to fit with the other kids around. And late one night, she took out her pen, and this is what she wrote down. Norma Jean wants to be a movie star. She wants to shine. Hear people say, "We know who you are." Norma Jean wants to see her name in lights. She wants to dance. She wants to live the good life. By the time she turned 16, she was 21. Knew every name on the silver screen and everything they'd done. But when it came time to lay herself down to dream, it wasn't them she saw up there. It was Norma Jean. Norma Jean wants to be a movie star. She wants to shine. Hear people say, "We know who you are." Norma Jean wants to see her name in lights. She wants to dance. She wants to live the good life. For too long, she had her fortune and fame. But it wasn't Norma Jean. Marilyn was her name. She died in L.A. in a lonely room. The final role she was to play, it ended much too soon. Though she's gone, she'll live on in our hearts and minds. A little girl that found a dream when she wrote down these lines. Norma Jean wants to be a movie star. She wants to shine. Hear people say, we know who you are. Norma Jean wants to see her name in lights. She wants to dance.
Sammi, that's beautiful. Beautiful job. I asked her if she would sing that especially for me, and I appreciate that very much, Sam. Roger, I think after that we need an upper here.
How's that? Anybody got one? No.
No, I thought we would reach into your vast array of musical talents.
My vast repertoire.
Yes.
Of backwash.
And I would ask you. That's probably where this fiddle playing is, too.
What was your first name again?
It doesn't make any difference.
It really doesn't.
I wondered if you'd play the fiddle for us.
Okay, Harvey, we'd love to. Harvey Emery, I've loved you for
have you?
Yes.
I'll tell him about...
I was one of the best fiddle players in the world.
No, I didn't know you were one of the best fiddle players
somebody
in the world.
Somebody just told me a while ago.
Really?
Out front, yes. Go ahead and say what you were going to say.
If you stay on my back, I'll get the record of Poor Little John out and play that. I don't know whether you ever knew that. Roger was, in his early career, had a hit record called Poor Little John. Well, not exactly a hit record.
Well, it wasn't a hit. It was a much-played record on Ralph Emery's show, and that's why I'm here today.
you actually play this?
I play the heck out of it. I'm a little out of practice, but it really gets good sometime, you know. Yeah.
Oh, my.
Isn't that wonderful?
My, my.
My, my.
I'm trying to be nice.
I know. You ought to hear us cook, though.
Really?
I mean, when me and Billy Ray Latham and the rest of the band get to going.
Oh, could you do that?
Oh, no.
Cook a little bit?
No, we're not in tune or anything like that.
Nothing's changed, has it?
Nothing's changed. We'd love to. Let's try the Devil's Dream.
What?
The Devil's Dream.
Oh.
What the hell do you say? I
We couldn't have Roger Miller on Pop Goes the Country without having King of the Road. So, ladies and gentlemen, the song you have awaited, Roger Miller and King of the Road.
All right. Trailers for sale or rent, rooms to let 50 cents, no phone, no pool, no pets,
ain't got no cigarettes, but 2 hours of pushing broom buys an 8x12 4-bit room. I'm a man of means, by no means king of the road. Third boxcar, midnight train, destination Bangor, Maine. Whoa, worn out suit and shoes, I don't pay no union dues. I smoke old stogies I have found, short but not too big around. And I'm a man of means, by no means king of the road. And I know every engineer on every train, all of the children and all of their names, and every handout in every town, and every lock that ain't locked when no one's around. I sing trailers for sale or rent, rooms to let 50 cents, and no phone, no pool, no pets. I ain't got no cigarettes, but 2 hours of pushing broom buys an 8x12 4-bit room. And I'm a man of means, by no means king of the road, the king of the road, the king of the road. Ba-do-do-do-do-do-dum. Thank you.
Miller,
yes,
thank you very much. You used to be interviewed, and each time the interviewer would say, "Where'd you write that song?" You would give a different town every time, would you?
Would I? I didn't think so.
I think you told me Des Moines, Iowa.
Well, it was between somewhere, I thought it was Dayton or Des Moines or somewhere in Chicago. I was going into Chicago, and I saw a road sign that said Traders for Sale or Rent. And from the rest is history.
Were you traveling as an entertainer then?
Yes, I was. I was very popular.
What?
My popularity was really gaining at leaps and bounds at that time. I had Dang Me and Chug Lug, and people were running after the bus, and it was just incredible. Dogs were chasing us. We had women that were hanging off the top of the bus, with skirts flying off and everything. We'd drive through towns, people would throw service caps in the air. It was like one of those ticker tape parades.
Before I forget, would you step over here and introduce your wife to our audience,
please? Well, I'd be happy to. You want me to do it?
Yes.
Just get off my cord. Just get off my bleep. This is my wife, Mary Miller.
Thank you.
Many of you probably remember a show called Rolling on the River with Kenny Rogers in the first edition. And for 7 years, Mary was their female singer, because she was the only female in the group.
Thank you.
So she was a female singer.
You, Mary, you have my deepest sympathy.
Thank you.
And my congratulations. Sammy, would you join us, please?
Okay, could
I hope they didn't catch all that. Sammy, I wondered, feeling all right? Don't let me push you.
I'm just having a good time.
If you're reviewing the Sammy Smith albums, you will discover there a Roger Miller tune called In the Summertime, when all the trees and leaves were green and all that. You Don't Want My Love. And as I remember, you used to sing this little tune around Nashville all the time, and nobody took it very seriously, did they?
I wrote it as a joke. It was a joke for Buddy Killen. And it became a very good joke. Andy Williams made a good joke out of it. And I saw Donnie Marie do it the other night.
Could we get maybe little Sammy and little Roger here to do it?
But probably so.
Take my mic.
Little Sammy and Big Roger, yes.
Sam and Roger.
You gonna try it?
Yeah.
Pow! Hey! Just start off with some rhythm. Chicken, 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 chicken. No, I don't think so. I think we can do it. In the summertime, when all the trees and leaves are green, and the redbird sings, I'll be blue, cause you don't want my love. Some other time, that's what you say when I want you. Then you laugh at me and make me cry, cause you don't want my love. Well, you don't seem to care a thing about me. You'd rather live without me than to have my arms around you when
Summertime, when all the trees and leaves are green, and the redbird sings, I'll be blue, 'cause you don't want my love. Hey!
I must tell you that I cornered Roger Miller in this building the other day and asked him if he would come and do this show. And he was kind enough to come and be with us. And it's been like shooting a prison riot. But I want to tell you, I want to thank you. What was the name of the band?
I have no idea. I don't know. This is the Lawrence Welk Orchestra. Oh. No, this is my... Wait, I just call them, I don't know, nothing, really. Drugstore Cowboys, you can call them.
California Car Strippers.
That's right, the Roger Miller, whatever, group, employees.
Anyway, I
whatever. Yeah, whatever, Roger
Could
Miller.
I say a serious word?
I doubt it.
I wanted to mention that when you used to be here, you seem to win all the Grammys. See there, you left, and you're not winning the Grammys like you used to.
But they got so mad that I won them all that they changed the laws.
How many Grammys did you win?
11.
In 1 year, how many did you win?
5, and next year we won 6.
Now, you mean they changed the rules?
You got a little bit. They didn't want me in that many categories, you know.
I know in 1 year you won everything but Best Female Vocalist.
Yeah.
And they gave that to Jody Miller.
Yeah.
you were mad about that, weren't you?
I didn't care. I was so high I could have gone duck hunting with a rake anyway. That was back then.
I wonder, pardon me, Mr. Miller.
Yes.
I want to thank Miss Sammi Smith, who flew all the way from Globe, Arizona, to be on the show. Yes, she's here.
Well, hello. Nice
you
to
know Sammi Smith?
Why, no, we've never met. Yeah.
I wonder if we... Sammi, thank you. Thank you, Sam. Now, I wonder if we could conclude this little episode, this week's episode, with Chug-a-Lug, another of your hits.
Did I record that?
Yes, you did.
Oh, my God, wouldn't that be good? Let's try it. You want to?
All right.
Chug-a-Lug, Chug-a-Lug, make you want to holler, hidey-ho, burns your tummy, don't you know? Chug-a-Lug, Chug-a-Lug, grape wine in a mason jar, homemade and brought to school by a friend of mine in after class. Man, hell, man, this the fool decided we'll drink up what's left. Chug-a-Lug, so we helped ourselves. First time for everything. My ears still ring. Chug-a-Lug, Chug-a-Lug, hey! Make you wanna holler, hidey-ho. Burns your tummy, don't you know? Chug-a-Lug, Chug-a-Lug, 4-H and a FFA. On a field trip to the farm, me and a friend sneak out behind this big old barn where we uncovered, discovered a moonshine still. Chug-a-Lug, so we thought we'd drink or fill. Yeah!